Hey guys, welcome to episode 7 of my Dishonored 2 Let's Play series. This is a high chaos Corvo Let's Play, just in case you haven't caught the previous episodes. And in the last episode we did the Royal Conservatory mission, and I had missed out on two bone charms because our primary target, Brianna Ashworth, carries two on her. And here's the thing. If you do it the lethal way and you have shadow kill, those bone charms will disappear with her body. You have to actually have a corpse to loot. So if you are going high chaos and you have shadow kill, it is suggested that you use like a knockout thing. And stun mine works best because one of the bone charms she carries means that any projectile, any kind of bolt, bullets, the first projectile you fire at her will turn into blood flies and alert her. So a stun mine to knock her out, and then loot her body, and then if you want to kill her after, that's fine, but just make sure you get bone charms before you make her body vanish. And so one of the bone charms does that, turns first projectile into blood flies, and the other one I think turns any summoned thing like rats or blood flies, turns any swarm against the summoner. I don't know why I'd want that. And also I looked and it doesn't look like there's an achievement for making sure you get every bone charm. So I just left it. I mentioned I might go back and get those two, but given how far back it was, like there were still several runes, bone charms, blueprints, etc. I had to go get after I killed her. And then given how complicated it is that I have to make sure I, you know, like you couldn't go to a later autosave and then go back up to her office and find the bone charms given that her body disappeared. So I have to start from there. I just didn't care enough. So I'm two bone charms down from completion, but that's where those were. So in this mission, we're going to meet with Anton Sokolov to discuss your next steps before taking this gift to the district. I think, because in the last episode, we had heard the name Aramis Sitlton, and he is, I think, who we're going to go check out next. And also, just a side note, I am recording this on my birthday. So if you want to give me a little birthday present, you can just subscribe to the channel. Get me towards that monetization goal. Way far away from it, but just figured I'd mention. Yes. Right in our journal. Okay, so that was our previous. So Brianna Ashworth and Delilah were infiltrating the minds of the sister of the Oracular Order. Okay, so he's hoping that taking up Brianna will help reduce her power here in Karnaka. Okay, yeah, Megan Foster had admitted she knew Brianna before, and she had gotten, like, caught up in Brianna and Delilah's business at some point, so. See what we have. Powers. So we got four runes. What am I saving towards next? Not devouring swarm. Dark vision. I tend not to really like those on playthrough because I tend to overuse it, so it'll just sepia tone everything. So this is blink. Redirected blank assault. I'm not coordinated enough for that kind of mess. Yeah, you can knock out enemies with like thrown objects if you have the improved strength. And this allows you to shatter weak or wooden doors with my sword. Warning, this is noisy. Bought this before. What's this? Health regeneration is improved. Might get that. Reflexes, block to defend projectiles. I don't think I've blocked once since the tutorial. I haven't been peering either. Agility. What's this? Sprint faster. Don't sprint a lot. Shadow kill. I don't want blood flash swarm. I just may need to make sure I get this. So, you know what? Let's go into strength. Why not? We can break down some wooden doors and then throw bottles at somebody's head to knock them out. And not waste my, crossbow bolts. Okay. Is this still just a mess? Ugh. I want to look through the boxes and get stuff. I want to talk to him. Let's go upstairs. And read Megan's diary. Looking at the tables. Eat. Bullet. Bullet. Okay, well, she's, keeping bullets next to her bed, so that's reassuring.
So, the oil detector is headed into the dust district. Corvo says he hasn't been back in a long time. I can't blame him for that. According to Sokol, he'll be trying to get into Aramis Stilton's house. Not easy. I've tried. Stilton was a friend. Even as a mine owner, he was a good man. Came up from working people. Never forgot it. I went looking for him the night he disappeared. But the house was swarming with the Grand Guard. I showed them what I was worth, but it cost me. I'll live to see that score settled.
Okay, so Aramis Stilton was looked up to by Megan because apparently he's a mine owner, but he was like very good to the people. And whatever happened. She tried to go finding out what happened, but the Grand Guard, it looks like, because you saw that she's missing an eye, she's missing an arm. So it looks like that might have happened when she was trying to figure out what happened to Aramis Stilton. Oh, actually full. Some rats in here. Sometimes there is just like a coin or two. It's new. Like around the ship. So you don't have to worry about it. There's usually nothing major. But I'll just come check just in case. Fishes, but it's carrying. It's carrying. Oops, let's go. Max out my health.
So many years ago, prison.
Okay. So Megan isn't on board at the moment. More bullets. I'll talk to you in a minute, so book. Okay.
So tired.
So He made me a spring razor, but I'm comfortable up at the moment. Yeah, this is definitely the more lootable area where there tends to be new loot each time. Usually coins or some kind of weapons or ammo. This time it's a spring razor. Got a full up on them.
Okay. I need to know why Delilah can't be killed. Everything we've learned implies that something strange happened to Darren Stilton's home 3 years ago, but then he disappeared.
Stilton lived in a bunker kept secure by a fancy lock made by a gin rush. Maybe inside we'll learn more about how to stop Delilah.
But I have to get there first through a ruin created by the Duke, where I used to live.
Regan had an intriguing idea. Howlo is leader of the Howlers. He wants Vice Overseer Byrne killed. And of course, Byrne wants Howlo dead too. Both groups will attack you on sight, but walk in with the corpse of their chief enemy, and they'll treat you like fire.
So that gives me at least one way into Aramis Stilton's house.
I'm pretty sure that would work.
Seeing it changed, running to the ground. Some people have reached beyond others. The old Batista neighborhoods, full of mining families, called the Dust District now.
Okay.
Vice Overseer Byrne. I dread each interaction with the Abbey.
So,
I knew plenty of people like Paolo growing up. Maybe not as crafty.
So basically, you can do this mission a number of ways. Like as
if I put people to work down in a mine, I'd want to live in a fortified bunker too.
You could say you could kill either of these and cart them into the opposition. Like, if I kill Paolo, I could bring him to the Overseers, and they'll actually be friendly enough to let me pass if I'm carrying his corpse. I mean, if you've allured them and killed fierce Overseers, then, you know, they might not be as friendly to you. Or you can kill the Vice Overseer, and Paolo's little gang will let you walk freely around there. You can also kill them both. Just go on a killing spree, and just loot everything. Might be what I end up doing, or I might kill one, bring it to the other so I can at least get more in to the depth of the location, and then end up killing the other. They're probably going to kill them both anyway. Or you can actually ignore them both, like, and go into the territories and just loot stuff while not killing them. Or you can actually solve Jindosh's luck yourself. It is, it's a little bit harder to do. I think there's actually even, if you go online, you can look up the, like, Jindosh lock for the mansion. And you can print out, like, a little puzzle solving thing. Because I think it's different for every game. It's one of those ones that changes each time. Which I will probably do that on my Low Chaos playthrough. Is just print out that little guide to solving the puzzle, and I will solve my puzzle without going into either of the territories. I'm not really good with puzzles though, so it might just be an exercise in frustration, but that's what I'm gonna do.
Let's go.
Get you as close as I can.
Well, it's good that he's feeling well enough to drive a boat around. Dust District. You must travel through the Dust District to Aramis Stilton's manor, which contains more of Delilah's secrets. Vice Overseer Byrne and his religious followers are at war with Paolo, leader of the Howler Gang. Either Byrne or Paolo will aid you for a favor.
didn't know Aramis Stilton. Who was he?
Loyal to the old Duke. Stilton helped build Modern Tanaka with those silver mines. Worked his way up from nothing. Fortified mansion. With the new Duke, spends money so fast. Mine goes work all day, nor night. District's in ruins. Doesn't try to tell anyone except most desperate.
The Duke of Sirkonos has made a mess of things. His father was a good man.
True, but the new Duke's misery had only been possible with Dunwall's support. In any case, maybe Stilton doesn't disappear. Maybe Stilton's still in there. Or maybe he's dead.
Yeah, I think if you're playing as Emily, she contemplates that she didn't really
find the maid once you reach the best district. She'll tell you more. I'll wait here and escape and take you back to the dreadful way after you finish.
Okay, so basically if you play as Emily, she's like, man, I really didn't keep an eye on, like, I wasn't really paying attention to the suffering of people in different districts. And she berates herself for basically being like, I just wanted to, get, you know, I just ignored all the people at the parties because I didn't want to be there. Well, that's flammable. Oop. Class for bolts. Oop. 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 Where am I supposed to go? Well, actually, while I'm here, I think I'm supposed to go that way somehow. Room 60. That might be the black market room. Oh, nope. Okay. I think I'm supposed to go up this way, but I'm just not sure where. Up this door right here. Okay, I think I'm in neutral territory. And it doesn't say. There's a wall of light. There's guards. So that ain't gonna be good. Wall of light, gotta get past there. Our guard's right there. Let's scooch this away. Be able to see me killing him. back from eating over there. More guards in this house. Get back up here. So I can turn the lights off. Over here. That's, I think, past the end of light. So there are guards in here somewhere. Heels.
Whatever that was.
That sounds like an assassin.
What? All right, chopper.
More of you? I have to shoot all y'all's. I've got pistols, so I can just replenish my ammo. Anyway, there are, let's see, 2 blueprints, I think, in this level, and then one that will respawn if you didn't get it earlier, and there are 3 paintings in this level, so, and they're all, the blueprints and paintings are all located pretty much in 2 locations, so, I want to mention that I might have to, like divide this up in between 2 things, but I forgot that the house itself is its own level, or its own mission, I should say. So 20 too much. Get some bullets. Don't we have to too much about splitting? Came running to the house. Okay, I kind of have to get down lower. I need to get in this building here. I think there was a flash of an alert, so there may be a guard that's still around. Which is bad because I came in the wrong way. another one. We'll get in these books. So I just came home. I went to a desk dormitory. Past the wall of light area. Yes. Freaking blood flies. A lot of blood flies. What do I have? I've got three. I'm actually going to save my incendiary because I will, I think, need those more in the mansion. Oh, what are we doing? Me too bad as far as health goes. Okay, something burned over there. I'm not sure why. Let's hide it for everything. I'm not eating a rotten one. Good body. Steps over there, so I'm gonna make sure I remember to drop down that way. So that just leads outside.
And the Howlers have divided up the district. Just ahead is neutral territory where no one will harass you. But further on, the Howlers and the Overseers both have boundaries set. And beyond those points, they'll attack you on sight.
And Stilton is the real goal. Sokolov said you worked out a plan.
Yes. I believe that if you take out Paolo or Vice Overseer Bruin, the other one will grant you safe passage and will help you get inside Stilton's home. Neutralize either one of them, and bring him to the end.
Got anything else?
Vern is protected by the Overseers. Paolo has the Howlers, but I think he's also got some kind of black magic charm. They say he's got to die twice before the sun sets, or he can't be killed. Good luck.
Okay. So if, you decide to kill Pablo, I can't even remember his name now. If you decide to kill him, you have to basically kill him twice. Or he just comes back to life. A way to get to that room with the room in it. Now I just gotta figure out how. Maybe I do have to go up there. Okay. Oh, she's gonna kill me if I do that. Okay. I know there's a way to do it. It's right below me here. And it's not necessarily like a possession thing. It's this like hole in the floor. Maybe I just gotta go up here. Go up here. Go down the level. Okay. Like, I knew there was some way to get in here. Okay. Any other loopholes? At least he isn't echoing at the moment. That's home. Okay, so we're all down here. So here's the neutral territory. Go over here. Here. And then we can go through here. This is all neutral.
The city's gone to shit. The district where I grew up, even more so. Time to slit some throats.
Okay. So, this is the Howler area. And I think over here is the Overseer area. And down there is the Black Market. This is the Silversmiths. No? Oh, this is the Black Market. The storm kicking up. Okay. Whoa, I'll take your ammo. Okay, I'm gonna leave you alone. You know you got a cash register, I'll leave you alone. Especially don't want to store up anything before I even gotten. See, there's the Black Market. But we're gonna do that right at the end. Blood in, or you did not. So those are some pallets outside. Did mark a new one. 50. I'm not sure which side I'm gonna go. Well, actually, I'm thinking what side I'm gonna go. Let's go down the Overseer side. Let's see. I think one thing enough to go break down some doors. I guess I'll get the quicker health replenishment thing. Oops, phone before. Ooh. But anyway, it's not worth that much, but I'm like, at least I give a reward for knocking down this nest. Yep. So it looks like that's about it for this building. Okay. I don't want to get in the wrong territory area, so it's just let's pick over here. It's in here. Elixir, a book, that's it. Well, actually, I can go up this way. Oh. So if you come in here, this is the neutral territory. This is Decky. Here is Aramis Stilton's mansion. So, they're, trying to break the lock, but she's like, look, man, I can't do this. So, you actually get you get, 5 last names of women, and then 5 kind of trinkets, and then you get a riddle. So, this is where you would go to try and solve it yourself. Is like I said, it's you'd have to like do various things, eliminate certain people from having certain things, and it have to be in a row. So this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, it could be any of these ladies in any of these rows. So if you don't want to sit there for 20 minutes or longer trying to solve it yourself, go out and explore. Okay. So, we're gonna go overseer first, but I do kind of want to peek into the black market, see what's going on. So there's some people standing in line for food. I'm gonna go through that in a minute.
Here, you know it's good for you.
Well, fine. I just wanted to buy something. So it looks like Paolo's harassing another black market person. Yeah, why not? So he's just giving me a hint that there's a back way into the crime castle. I wonder who that could be. Let's see what you got.
This is what I have for upgrading your equipment.
Let's just leave dark. I don't care about that. Do I want a mock? You know what? See, once installed, a masterwork upgrade cannot be removed. If you install the dealer, you won't be able to install coffin nails later. So this is where you can aim lock three targets at once. This fires bolts at a high rate. Actually, I don't want you to. I don't care about
this. Little lure scares off buyers. What's worse, overseer zealots or cutthroat howlers?
Maybe I'll get my extra bone charm. I don't think I really have anything else. Yeah, I'll get extra bone charms for now. And that'll be it. Well, I'll take a look and see if there's something I want, like a safe code in your inventory. A map of Aramis Stilton's home. I don't care about that.
This rate.
Okay.
Come back soon. I'm still here.
Okay, so she doesn't actually have a room in her shop. So that we're gonna crawl through here. Sneak around. So I'm in hostile territory now. You need to be careful coming around here. Because there are going to be traps, I think. Oopsie, there's one here. I can't remember which direction it fires from. It must be coming up there. So, can I get on these poles? Yes. Nope. Oh, you don't see me. Where's the trap? Oh, there's tripwire. Okay, so anyway, you do want to come back here. And you want to knock that piece of wood off the door. You can see I'm in the overseer area. I'll come back to that door I just bolted. That's basically how you get the black market robbed in this area, is you need to knock that piece of wood off. And that building right here, behind this little pipe, that's the main. There's something of a trap here. And the pouch that's doing a little jig. Looks like there's a breakable windows in there. Me, I think they were executing somebody. Oh, burn. Money. Okay. Took somebody come here to be a miner and I think they're executing Howlers that we caught. Platforms back here behind these wood things. I can't see them, so I'm going to do a quick save before I do this blink. Okay, this is the overseer. Overseer thing. You want to be creeping the entire way, because even if the guards wouldn't see you, they could hear you, and there's also hounds that can hear you better than the guards. So locked from the inside. Pain in the butt. Can I make it over here? Oh, still can't make it over there. That's the ground floor. I don't really want to go into the ground floor. So. Any closer? Any better for getting me over there? Okay, it's locked from the inside, but if I were to... That was a waste of crossbow bolt. Okay, I can get to the lamp. That's good. Doesn't look like I can actually do an entry into that building. Let's move this way. I'd say one of these buildings over here is actually an old. That one. building. I don't see an entry point. Looking for an entry point. Maybe I'm at the wrong location. But I want to see what's right next to the overseer building. No open windows for me to get in there. Building open. It's not building. And an open window, so that's good. Anybody see or hear that? This guy looks like he's going somewhere. There you go. Didn't even notice you there. You didn't even notice me here, so you're not that observant. Okay. So technically I have the strength to knock down the door. I don't necessarily. guess I'll pick this up. Bullets. Pistol bullets. Pistol bullets. Oh, another tool. Oh. Ingots. And another one. Okay, that's pretty far away. Anything up on the upper floor? Doesn't look like it would go to the lower floor. No, that's 99. Six. Okay, well, I'll mark that because that seems to be the furthest away from anything. The others look like they're more grouped together. So, let's hit up the floor. This is, I think, Vice of Overseer Burns' floor. He does have more overseers to kind of hang out on this floor. But I'm going to... You see nothing. There's that guy. Looks like there might be guys in the office. I think one of the paintings is up here in this kind of like dilapidated area. Solution down on the floor. I think the voices I'm hearing are just from the floor below. They're actually on this floor. Okay, so this is in the dilapidated part of the heavy, so maybe I just missed it. Let's just take a look around. It's not there. here. And then go back to the first way. Here somewhere. So that's actually Burns. That's the overseer right there. Okay, so he doesn't vanish, even though I have Shadow Kill. And then someone's gonna come check on me. Maybe not, but they were just kneeling. Okay, so here's another part of the dilapidated floor. There's the painting. The first painting in this overseas outpost. Everything else is in the Crone Hand's saloon. So, because of the mission options, here's the locked window, so I'm unlocking that so I can escape by there. Oh, I missed that bone charm somehow. Let's see. So, I found Durante's items. That's the the Howler that they abducted, because they found out that he knew the lock to Irma Stilton's home. His work. So now I have to get out of the Overseer District with this corpse. I'm in neutral territory, but I will be attacked. or will be attacked by overseers. Letting me through, and it's considered neutral territory now. So I'm bringing him to the Crone's Hand Saloon. Normal, this is hostile, unless you're carrying the Vice Overseer's corpse. And like I said, if you've been hostile to them before, it does seem to freak them out a bit. To talk to him, I'm gonna wave my weapons. There's that bone charm still over there. There's a rune there. I think that I have to have my sword out. But listen. Yep, sorry for my sword being out. So I'm gonna kind of hang out here. There is a basement. Oh, that's what was down here. And in the basement, there's bone charm. I didn't check the others. Let's see what we got. Bitter blood, the plus attack of sort of shred distance. Hot cocktail by 7. Exploding bottles affect. Yeah, so if I have a flammable bottle, I'll throw it at a nest. Okay. Recipe for some kind of potion. They're torturing you back. Here we go. Here's blueprint. So this blueprint number one. Now we have two more paintings fine. I think they're both upstairs along with the other. It's for me, because I don't think I can use power dust. I can't use it. That was a dowel thing. And see, that's where you could get into the basement if you were kind of trying to sneak in here. Same recipe we were talking about on the last one. Okay. So let me see what I actually got from. Okay, so you bring the body actually does unlock the code for you. But, as you saw, I got Durante's solution to the Jindosh lock. And we got his belongings. So this is his room. And this is what you would do if you didn't want to, like, bring a body. You would go and sneak and get his stuff. And he has the code in his room. Okay, so I got the key to the Silver Graph. And that has a lot of valuables in there. So if you want to increase your I think he might get upset if I take the money off of his table. There's nobody here. I'll take that money. That's kind of like how what I wanted. Yep. Let me do that. So that's the outside of him. There's a bone charm over here. Where should I go? Let me go get that bone charm. In his room and I just missed it. Yes. It's hiding behind me. Okay, what's the Assassin's Fortune? Bolt packs have a slight chance of containing. Yes, please. Crossbow bolts I tend to have run out of more quickly than bullets because I try to be silent when I can. Crystal bolts. Having fun using crossbow bolts on the poster. But given that that means it's more for me, I'm fine with it. And here is the second blueprint. I was like, what am I supposed to look for? Yeah, don't face me while I'm fixing it. Robbie. Anything in here? No. The other two paintings I think are upstairs. It's just the Howlers being noisy. The bathroom. Okay, now I'm going up to Jindosh's actual room. Don't know if this makes me hostile at any point or not. Okay, the outsider shrine is over there. I want to do that last. So the back way there. Painting number one that's in here, or painting number two for the actual level. And there's painting number three right there. So this is saying it's kind of easy to keep track of all the stuff.
I remember that name.
It's all in basically two locations. My cursor right there. Okay, the chrome hand that he's talking about that Paolo has, that allows him to have an extra chance at life, like that's why you have to kill him twice in the same day for him to actually die. That chrome hand is actually believed to be the hand of the, what's it called, Granny Crone, the old crone from the first game. That's believed to be her hand because she was a marked outsider follower. Anything up here? Blood bleeding. Hey guys, what you doing? Something interesting up here? Doesn't really look like it. That just goes off into the void. Okay. Alright, let's that's if you want to exile him. You can non-lethal them both. Both the Vice Overseer and Paolo. And you can ship them both off at the silver graphs, but I'm not going to do that. I'm just going to loot the silver graphs because I can't be bothered to make myself hostile to so many people. Let's see, that's Paolo. I don't want Paolo. I want Just the silvers. Yeah. It's basically one of these shop fronts. This is... Here we go. Found it! So it's basically right outside of Howler territory. I'm not going for a step. Yep. There's Bentron. Close. Also, I thought I saw Bentron over here. Maybe not. It's pretty close though. This is where you would put the two that's supposed to be money for shipping them. But I'm just gonna take the money. Okay. So yeah, there is some cash worth having in here. But it's not a substantial. This is basically if you want to non-lethal them both out of the way. Sacrifice. What does that do? Oop. Sacrifice. Killing Gliflies and Rats stores. Well, not to restore my mana at the moment. I was in here somewhere just because I can hear some buzzing around. Beautiful. Yeah, that's not the window I shot through. This is a different... Flip on this. Oh, got a basement. Got a creepy, creepy basement. Actually, so there is another bone trap. I thought there was another bone trap, so I have to go find that. Good. What's in here? Oh, sounds kind of weird. Sounds like some wet chewy noises from somewhere. Mindy Pritchard, Mindy Blanchard.
So Paolo has a secret. That's useful to know.
actual lootables in this. Nope. Okay. There's nobody in there. That's closed. Where's the black market again? That's to the overseers. I can get them here. Okay, so. Overseer. Power. Aren't the opposite side of something? Okay, let me just I don't want to kill you. I just want all your valuables. $20. I'm making it worth my while. In the food too. Come on. Get out of y'all's house. It's a bedroom. Y'all just brick yourselves in. It's the actual door to the exit. Okay, so I am in overseer territory. Is there a window closer to that? Bedroom. Open the bathroom. You see it's bricked in. Okay. There. back somewhere. There's the entry to the Overseer area. I walk on this book. It does not look like it. I can't. Can I now? Go blank onto it. So I think this is the back way I came. Is it? No. To get moved. Cans, Corvus, I'll tell you what. Okay. Here's the dentist office. Looks like we've got some overseers kind of walk their way up over here. I'm just trying to get back into into territory now. I think that bone charm. Actually, where we want to go as far as there's still a trap down there. So we can, whoop. There we go. Some cinder bolts. There we go. So now I'm just going to head back from here. I'm going to make sure that bone charm's the only one I see. And I can't remember if the crone's hand on Paolo is a bone charm. If it's just, like, elutable. But, so I might be missing a bone charm when all said and done. So it's so these are the two blueprints I got in this level. Sticker grenade. So I can actually buy these at the black market now. And my spring razors were now work twice.
Let's see. Actually, I have some upgrade plans for your gear.
I don't think I'll actually ever buy sticker grenades.
To do business. Only if it's so dust I'd be rich.
But you know what? I'm gonna buy it anyway, because that means if they sell grenades, that means that there's a sticker grenade I can loot when I rob it. Say it again. The black market has this door with a 3-digit code on it. The 3-digit code is in this apartment that, as you saw, it's because it must be in the black market. But as you saw, there was a piece of wood blocking the door, so you have to unblock the piece of wood. So there it is. You have to unblock a piece of wood before you can get in here, because this is where the code is. So. Now, see, there's this. The code is going to be on this calendar somewhere. As you can see, there's various things circled. I think you have to find a piece of paper if you want to decipher it by yourself. So I'll find that. Get some bread. You're unconscious, so I'll leave you be. So if you've been having a ball with some booze. Not a clue to the... Here we go. Wet in the month of rain. I love without refrain. So, the wood in the month of rain. Okay, so the circle in that row is 2-7, and I think it's always going to be this 4 in this first thing. So it's always 4, and then depending on what month you the thing says, it's always that. So since I have rain, that's in the... It's going to be 2-7. So either the month changes or the numbers that are circled changes. So I'm going to get my sleep darts out just in case. It was 4-2-7. Okay, so then do a little save just in case I massively mess it up. Yeah. Unfortunately, Paula's not going to be happy with her. You see the bone charm. If you want to get this bone charm, you have to rob the thing. I guess you could break in and just take that. What bone charm is that? I keep hitting the wrong thing. Always hitting the wrong thing. Actually, while I'm here, get some career vitality. What do I want next? I need to save some for that. Okay, I'll get that next. So I need 3 rings for that. Oh, that's right. Oh, I originally went there for bone charms. Bone charms. What's new? This. Watch sword. More easily. Is that what I got? Ooh, maximum mana is increased. Change this out for that. Okay. Oh, that's right. What was I doing? I'm robbing. Product in store. I like to do the little display cases out front last. For some reason, I feel like I need to be sneaking while I'm robbing the thing. You do not have a lot. Me to loot here. I mean, I know the dust district is supposed to be kind of gone to the dogs, but you have a bone charm, some bullets, and then whatever you got in the shutters. I got a map at home. Sweet dogs, bullets. Cluster bolts, mirror bolts, grenade, stun mine, sticker grenade, spring razor. So I've already gotten a sticker grenade from that upgrade. Okay. I'm going to do one last check for charms and rings. Because for some reason, I'm just all over the place today as far as trying to remember to get them. Okay. Yep. That my print shop is closed. It's nowhere. Where's that staircase leading? I've got this staircase, huh? Okay. Let's see. Market shop. And kitchen notch as well now. I think I've gotten everything I can, except for, I don't know if Paulo has bone charms on him. And see, thankfully, if you've gotten the clue about the way this goes, it shows you what it's supposed to be, so. Here's a bird. Oops, I passed it. I passed it again. Bird. Okay. Cactus Conti. There's a diamond. Okay. Winds low. There's a ring. Finch. hence the snuff tin. I guess what that is. And not swoo. It's a war medal. Here we go.
That's it. The information was good.
Okay. So that actually ends the level there. And the mansion itself is its own level. So we killed 17 people. I think most of those were guards at the very beginning and then some overseers when we were doing that. Two bodies detected, 5 detections. Okay. So not too bad. I mean, it was lethal, but it was more stealthy than assault. 5 runes, 1 outside of shrine. 5 out of 8 bone charms. So I'm wondering if Paulo did have some on him. About 2/3 of the coins, thereabouts. All the paintings, all the blueprints. I sided with Paulo and the Howlers. And then I broke into the black markets. Those are the extras I did. A crack in the slab. A strange ritual was performed 3 years ago in Aramis Stilton's manor, involving Delilah Copperspoon and her followers. What's inside? Find out what you can about Delilah's secrets.
Time is an odd thing. I left her not decades ago, excited about all that Dunwall might hold. I remember falling in love with Jessamine, watching her crowned as Empress. Emily's birth, the rat play, then Jessamine's death and another coronation. Now all this, back in the city where I was born, how many more lives do I have to take before it all ends? Stilton's home hides a mystery, but I'll tear it apart brick by brick to learn the secret of Delilah's immortality. As long as this ends watching her cough blood, Delilah might have pulled herself up from nothing, but I ran out of sympathy. Tyrants and witches a long time ago. All I want is to put an end to Delilah and make sure Emily is safe. One more time.
Okay. So we are going to end it there.
Definitely odd. Something just shifted.
Okay. We're going to stop there because this is his own mission. But thank you for watching this episode, everybody. Like I said at the beginning, think about giving me a subscribe. Like the video. You can follow me on Twitter at Old Maid Games, where I post when new videos go live. You can also be able to vote on future games that I play on this channel by becoming a patron. The Patreon link is in the description below. You can also support me at streamlabs.com/oldmaidplaysgames. Thank you for watching, everybody, and I'll see you in the next episode. Bye-bye.